This is how to use the Oxford University Press ebooks that we're all using. And I think that you will see that it's very easy to use the books, whether it's during the class with the teacher giving you exercises that we'll check together, or if it's homework at home, or even if you want to do extra practice. So once you are at the home page of your Oxford Learner's Bookshelf, you click sign in. Because you already have an account, you're not going to register, and you will enter your college email address. And the password that you use for Oxford, it may be the same as college or not. I think that's up to you. When it opens, you will be at the bookshelf. So you don't need to worry about the reading diary or certificate, just go to My Books. If you are year two, you will have the Effective Academic Writing 3, Inside Reading 2, or Lecture Ready 2. If you need to learn how to download those, there's a previous video that explains that, and you can watch that in your free time. I suggest pausing and following the steps as it goes. Let's just look at Inside Reading. Click the book, and in a few seconds, it will open up to the cover page. It's pretty simple to navigate. You just click this gray arrow to the right, and you go through some of their introductory stuff until you finally reach the first exercise, the first set of exercises and lessons. Okay, and don't worry, you don't have to do this every time you open the book. All right, so let's say that we're going to even practice the self-assessment. The first thing you'd want to do is zoom in so you can see better. And all of the functions, including Zoom, are accomplished using the toolbar at the top of the screen. That's this black bar. The magnifying glass with the plus symbol is for zooming in. So you can zoom in once or even twice, even more if you like. I think this is a little bit too large for me, so I'm going to go to the magnifying glass with the minus sign to zoom out just a bit. And now I see what I want. So even if I'm doing the self-assessment, I might decide that I want to check the right box. I can do that by going back to the toolbar, where there's a pencil symbol. It says pens, it looks like a pencil. You can figure out what it is. Choose a color, let's go with blue. And you can choose the thickness of the pencil stroke here by pushing plus to make it thicker, or minus to make it smaller. And okay, I want to say that I use this word confidently in speaking or writing, so I'll just put a check there. Okay, for create, I think I'm very, very familiar with that word, so I'll check there, and so on. It's very easy to use this function. Now, if you accidentally make a mark that you don't want, you can erase by going up to this eraser. It's next to the pen colors, and you can probably make it a little bit wider. It just makes it easier to erase. And you scribble over the area that you want to clear, and it's done. You can use the remove all tool that looks like a trash can, but it will literally clear your screen. So don't do that if you still have some things that you want to keep. I'll just show you how it works. If I push remove all, then I get a warning asking me if I'm sure, and I just push okay. Now it's clear. Okay, basic stuff. When you don't want to write anymore, you just click that pen button. So now you can actually use your mouse again. If you want to scroll with the page, you can click and drag here, or click and drag with the scrolling bar on the left. Let's go to the next page. Okay. Everything that you want to see, everything that you would normally see in the book is in the ebook, of course. There are exact copies of each other. So You can start to do any exercise that you want to do. Let's say that you're reading and you have some part that you don't understand. For example, there's a new word and you want to remember it. You can go to the highlighter tool next to the pen. Once you click that, you have choices of color. Again, I'll go with purple. You can increase the width of your highlighter by clicking that plus button. And I will say that I don't know this word, opal. Okay, so I highlight the word, fine. It's something that I can remember for later to look up if I want to see a picture. And the nice thing about this book is that I can save. So even if I want to ask the teacher in the next class about something and I highlight it, I can save, and everything that I wrote or marked in the book will be there. And in fact, the book will open to the exact same page. So let's try that. Save and close. All right. So let's pretend it's the next day and I want to open my book again to read some more or review. I click inside reading and I'm not on the cover page anymore. I'm on the last page that I was using, and I even have the marks that I put on that page. Okay, so these are the very basic functions of just being able to use your book like a physical book that you are used to. And the good thing about this is you don't have to erase whatever you write because you're not going to return this book. Basically, what you have is your own digital copy to use any way that you like. And I hope that you got a good sense of the things that you can do to complete the exercises and assignments that you'll have, whether it's in class or as homework. Okay?